Good day guys, welcome back to Kotlin Programming. In this video, we'll discuss about looping in Kotlin. But before we discuss about looping, we need to talk about ranges a little bit because majority of our examples in looping will be using the range feature. So Kotlin provides a feature for you to easily create a range of values. A range is a group of numbers with a specific interval between them. For example, the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so the operator being used to define a range is the double period. So like this. So let's say we declare a variable number. So var number is equals to 1, double period, then 5. So the minimum value of the range is 1 and the maximum is 5. So now our variable number will contain a range of number between 1 to 5. So how are we going to use it? So by using it in the loops. So loops are used for iterating on a collection of objects, usually arrays, maps, dictionaries, and just to name a few. You can also use loops to repeat a specific block of code as long as the defined condition is true. So let's create an example. First is the for loop. Now in other languages, for loop has a construct of something like this. So for int I is equals to 0, I is less than or equals to 10, I plus plus. And then here is the block or the body of our for loop. So as you can see, we have the declaration part of the control variable, the condition part, and the incrementation and or decrementation part, and the body part that can be executed as long as the condition part is true. So in Kotlin, you can do looping like this. So for I in 1 double period and 5, then the body. So here's our loop. Now let's run it first so that you can see the output of our program. So here we've just printed the value 1, 2, until the number 5. So let's go back here in the code. Things that you will notice is that it is very compact. You can have a control variable that you don't need to declare, this I, and the condition part is replaced with in keyword, which is used to check that a value belongs to a range or a collection. So if you read this, it is basically saying for as long as I is within the range of between 1 to 5, since the range is defined as integer, the counter variable I will be integer also and will be initialized to the lowest value of the range. So in this case, it is 1. You can also do a reverse loop, like from highest to lowest. So let's say from 1 to 5 to 5 to 1 by using the downTo operator. So let's create another loop here and put some separator here, a print line. So for j in 5 down to 1, then the same print. So here the j will be, the j's initial value will be 5, and then it will be deducted by 1. That's why we use the operator down to, and the minimum value will be 1. So by default, the value is incremented or decremented by 1. But you can change that value by specifying a step value. So let's say you want to deduct the value by 2s. So let's say 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and not 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can do like this. So let's add another separator here. So for k in 0 to 10, so double period 10, step 2, it means that it should increment by 2, and then let's print the value, and then let's run the program. So as you can see, it increments from 0 to 4, 6 until 10. So the counter variable is incremented by 2. So that is basically the for loop. There are other types of loops in Kotlin as well. There is the do while and the while loop. You can write a while loop like this. So var counter is equal to 0, while counter is less than or equals to 10, print line counter, and then counter plus plus. So here you can see that we declare a counter variable and initialize it to 0, then use it on a condition part, then whatever you want to do. So here we just printed the value, the current value of the counter, and then we incremented the counter variable using the plus plus sign. So that is the while loop. And then we have the do while loop. So you can write do while loop like this. So var, so let's declare another variable, that's a number, is equal to 1. So do print line number, and then number plus plus, and then the condition part will be below, while number is less than or equals to 10. So the only difference of do while to while loop is that do while loop will run its body at least once, whether the result in the condition part is true or false. But in the while, it will go into check first the condition part. If it is true, if it is false, then it will skip entirely the whole loop. So let's try another example. So let's say you need to print an unknown number of star character, and you need the input of the user to do this. So let's write print, how many stars do you want to print? And then let's use the input coming from the user. So var number is equal to input.nextInt. And then for I in 0 until number. So, and then print the character star. And then the body of our for loop. So here I use the until keyword. So if you want to iterate a number, if you want to iterate on a number range which does not include its end element, you can use the until keyword. So like so, you can do this also in while loop. So like this, var x equals to 0, while x is less than num, print, and then x plus plus. So here we declare a counter variable, then set the condition until the value of x is equals to num, then print the star, then lastly incremented the value of x. So that's the basics of looping in Kotlin. So to review, we can use loops to iterate on a collection and to execute a particular block of code as long as the condition is true. And we can use the for loop, while loop, and do while loop. The for loop is usually for iterating on arrays and collections. And you can use the downTo keyword to reverse the sequence of the loop. You can use the step to specify the number of steps for each incrementation or decrementation. And you can use the until to specify a range that has a variable as end element. So that's it, guys. Thank you for watching, and if you have any question, please feel free to write in the comment sections below. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do so. Just click the subscribe button below. Thanks, and see you guys.